today I will discuss what is wave function. Now, for every wave, there is a variable quantity associated with the wave that gives the space and time behavior of a moving quantum mechanical particle. If you consider light wave, that is electromagnetic wave. So, what is the variable quantity associated with the wave? That is electric field and magnetic field. Electric field and magnetic field can vary. If you consider water wave, then the height of the water level, that varies. So for every wave, there is a variable quantity associated with it. Now, wave function. What is the definition of wave function? Wave function is the variable quantity associated with the de Broglie wave that gives the space and time behavior of a moving quantum mechanical particle. Now, how the wave function is denoted? Wave function is denoted by psi. That is psi, that is a function of x and t. What is x? X is the space and t is the time. So, psi, that gives the space-time behavior of a moving quantum mechanical particle. Now, this is written in one dimension. Now, if we want to write it in three dimension, then we can write it as psi or t. Again, this is space and this is time. Now, we have to know why we will know the wave function of the particle. What is the significance? If we know the wave function of a particle, then we can find out the probability of finding the particle at a given space at a given time. Then what is the relation between wave function and the probability? So for that, we have to know what is probability density. Now, what is the definition of probability density? Probability density is probability of finding the particle per unit volume at a given instant of time. Now, probability density is given as psi star psi. Then what is this psi star? This is the wave function. But what is this psi star? This is complex conjugate of psi xt. Now, if psi equal to a plus ib, then psi star, we can write it as a minus ib. So this is psi star is the complex conjugate of psi. If you take psi equal to e to the power I k x, then what is psi star? Psi star is e to the power minus I k x. But if psi equal to sin x, then psi star is also sin x. So here it is not changing. The value of psi and psi star is same. But here, the value of psi and psi star is different. I is changing to minus I. So, this is the complex conjugate of psi star, psi. Now, we will write probability density as, we can write it as mod psi xt square. That means mod psi xt square equal to what? Psi star xt into psi xt. So this is probability density. Now, if we want to find out probability from this, then we have to multiply probability density with the volume, because probability density is probability of finding the particle per unit volume. Now, if we know the total volume, then we will multiply and we will get the probability. Now, what is the formula of probability? The formula of probability is, say, I am writing mod psi xt square. Now, it is in one dimension. It is the wave function of a particle moving along the positive x-axis. Now, this is the probability density. Now, as it is one dimensional, so we are representing the volume as dx. Here, no dy and dz component. Actually, volume dv equal to what? Dx into dy into dz. But as it is one dimensional, so I am not considering that dy dz part, and dx is acting as volume. So, this is the probability mod psi square dx. Now, if we want to find out probability between x1 to x2, then we will write it, we will integrate over x1 to x2 mod psi xt square into dx. So, this is the formula of what? The probability. And this is probability density. Now, if we know the wave function of the particle, then from there we can find out the probability of finding the particle at a given space. That is, for that reason, wave function is very important. Now, if we write this, that minus infinity to plus infinity mod psi xt square dx, what is the value of this? We are considering the whole region, so the value will be 1. That is the total maximum probability, the value is 1. This is the probability. Now here we are taking the region, integrating over minus infinity to plus infinity. As the particle must be somewhere in the space, the total probability of finding the particle is 1. So this is very important equation, and this is this equation is very important. So we will remember this formula. Now, if I give you one example that one particle is moving along the positive x direction, and let the wave function of the particle is psi equal to bx, and it lies in the region between x equal to 0 to x equal to 1, and the value of psi x equal to 0 in other regions. Now we have to find out what will be the probability of finding the particle between x equal to 0.30 to x equal to 0.70. So we have to find out the probability of finding the particle between x equal to 30 to x equal to 70. Now we know the formula probability, what? X1 to x2 mod psi xt square dx. Now here, what is the value of x1? The value of x1 is 0.3 and it is 0.7. Now mod psi xt square, that is psi star xt into psi xt into dx. Now the value of psi xt, what is given as psi xt equal to bx. Now this value is bx. Now what is this value? This is the complex conjugate of this. That is the psi has value equal to bx, and there is no imaginary one. So as we considered that if psi equal to sin x, then psi star equal to sin x, so no change. But if there is any imaginary quantity, then it will be changed to plus I to minus y. So here no I, so psi star can be written as bx, again dx, that remains. So probability is what? B is some constant, so put b square outside, 0.3 to 0.7 x square dx. now b square, integrate it, x is cube by 3, so 0.3 to 0.7, so b square by 3, then you can find out the putting the values, just put the value here, and ultimately if you calculate, you will get 0.105 b square. So this is the probability, this is the probability of finding the particle between x equal to 0.3 to x equal to 0.7. for the particle, what we have taken, the value of wave function is given as bx, and the wave function exists between 0 to 1, but in other regions it has 0 value. So in this way, if we know the wave function of a particle, we can calculate the probability of finding the particle. We can find out the what will be the probability density of that particle. Okay.